So this is a very interesting problem. So here you have a function called fib. Basically, this stands for Fibonacci series. You might have learned this in programming and things like that, right? So fib of n, if n equals to 0, return 0. If n equals to 1, return 1. Else return fib n minus 1 plus fib n minus 2. So the function fib is like this, right? Fib of n is equal to 0 if n equals to 0. 1 if n equals to 1, and it is fib of n minus 1 plus fib of n minus 2 otherwise. Okay, I'll just write otherwise as OW. So you have two base cases here. If you think about it, there are two base cases. Okay, and you have a recursion here. Note that this is not tail recursion. This is not tail recursion. This is very, very important. A lot of people get confused with this. Just because you have recursion in the last line doesn't make it tail recursion, because whatever value fib n minus 1 returns and whatever value fib n minus 2 returns, both of them now need to be added. So there is this addition operation before you return. So this is not tail recursion, just FYI. Okay. Now the question here is, what is the time complexity of running this? So let's write the recurrence relation for it. So as soon as you see a recursion function, right? A recursive function, you should write the recurrence relation. So t of n is t of n minus 1, because I have these two recursions, plus t of n minus 2, plus some constant time, because all of these are constant operations, right? Including this addition. Now we want to solve this. Now let's go back to solving the recurrence relations, right? So I have t of n equals to t of n minus 1 plus t of n minus 2 plus c. My favorite always is the recursion tree method, because it's so visual and I can understand it better, right? Of course, there are cases where master theorem and extended master theorem help, but this is my favorite. There are many ways of solving this. My favorite is always to draw, because I can visually feel it. So problem of size n is broken down into problem of size n minus 1 and n minus 2. And to combine both of them, I need c operations. Again, this problem is broken down into n minus 2, n minus 3. This is broken down into n minus 3 and n minus 4. Right? So to combine both of them, again, I need c. To combine both of them, again, I need c. So 2 into c. Now, again, this will get broken up into n minus 3, n minus 4. This will again get broken up to n minus 4, n minus 5. Let me write it actually. N minus 4, n minus 5. This is again the same, n minus 4, n minus 5. This will get broken into n minus 5 and n minus 6. Now I have 4. I have this, I have this, I have this, I have this that I need to combine. So I have 4 of them. 4 into C. You're seeing already the pattern, right? This is 2 square into C. Again, each of them would get broken into 2. Right? Each of them would get further broken down into 2. So in the next level, what would I have? I have 8 of them. Right? I have 2 cube into C. So on so forth till the time I get 1. When I have only one element, right? Because when my n is equal to 1, I know that I have to return 1. Right? So, but look at this. The depth here, the depth of this tree here, the depth of the recursion tree. From n, you're going to n minus 1, to n minus 2, to n minus 3, so on so forth up to 1 on this side. On this side, you're subtracting by 2. N, n minus 2, n minus 4, n minus 6. Here you'll have n minus 8. So the tree on the right side is going to be shorter than the tree on the left side. It's important to understand that. It may not hurt our analysis much, but it's important to understand. So there will be some. So in the last layer, okay. So this tree, this path on the right side is going to be slightly shorter. Okay. Not slightly. It's going to be shorter actually than the path on this side. Right. That's because here you see you're decrementing by 1. Here you're decrementing by 2. So you will have some of them. Right. For example, here you might have 2 power n minus 1 into C. You'll have something less than equal to 2 power n minus 1 into C. You will not have exactly 2 power n minus 1 into C comparisons, because some of these, this paths would have terminated much earlier, right? This path would have terminated probably here, and while this path went on to here, right? So in the time complexity analysis, because we want big O of something, we want an upper bound, right? Here we are not looking for a tight bound. We are just looking for an upper bound. Since we are looking for an upper bound, that's okay. Let's stay with this. Now, when I sum up all of them, what do I get? My Tn is less than equal to right? Let's look at C plus 2C plus 2 square C plus 2 cube C, so on so forth, 2 power n minus 1 C. Why did I put a less than equal to here? Because some of these, because this tree, this path would terminate earlier than this path. So in the last level, I may not have these many joints to take care of, or these many combinations that I need to take care of. And that's why I've written less than equal to here. But that's okay, because we want a upper bound. We are not looking for a tight bound or a lower bound here. We're looking for an upper bound, right? So what does this mean? This means my T of n is less than equal to some constant times, right? 1 plus 2 plus 2 square, so on so forth, up to 2 power n minus 1. And this is a simple geometric series, right? So this is equal to C into 2 power n, sorry. So that's equal to, okay, let me just erase this, sorry. So that's equal to 2 power n minus 1. So this is exactly equal to this, which means you can ignore this constant here because it's a constant multiplier. This is a constant subtraction, you can multiply. So your Tn is less than equal to 2 power n, which means your Tn is upper bounded by 2 power n. So the time complex is upper bound. So if you look at big O notation, again, this is not big theta. Very important. This is not big theta. This is big O only, right? Because of this less than equal to here. Because this tree, this path is going to be much deeper than this path. There are some tight analysis. There's a very tight analysis that you can do for Fibonacci series using some advanced mathematics. But for now, what we care about is the big O notation. So it is big O notation of 2 power n, which is actually crazy high, right? While this recursion looks very simple, its time complexity is crazy high. And it's very important to realize that it's not tail recursion.